What is emotion?
Yeah, well, that's a, I suppose that's a very important question to ask when it comes to frequently asked questions about emotions.
Yeah.
And it's interesting, nobody actually asked that question, but let's focus on what emotions really are. Emotions are energy that comes from within the soul of an individual, mm-hmm. that's projected outwards. Now, the energy has to flow before it comes in an emotion.
Yeah.
In other words, it has to be energy in motion.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, it's flowing, and so now it becomes an emotion. If you sit on the energy, if you don't let it flow, then, of course, it's not an emotion. It's just a potential emotion at that point.
Yeah.
The way the soul works is that our personality is expressed through emotion. And in fact, emotions are a major part of the soul and how it functions. And for this reason, this energy that gets bound up inside of the soul needs a form of release. Now, how it gets released depends on what you do or what kind of emotion is expressed. So, for example, if the energy that's stored up in the soul happens to be feelings of joy, then the emotion flowing out of you, if you allow the emotion of joy to flow out of you, you know, you'll start seeing a smile on the person's face. They usually become, you know, quite enlivened as well, and their eyes, you know, sparkle. All of these are outward expressions of the flow of the energy from the soul to both of the bodies, the spirit body and the physical body. But the energy begins in the soul and flows out of the soul, and it flows into other people's soul bypassing the physical and spiritual bodies. In other words, the energy doesn't flow out of the spirit body, mm-hmm. but rather flows directly out of the soul to the soul of another person. Now, of course, you can prevent that energy from flowing into you or out of you,
yep.
through blockages and resistance and suppression and denial and all of these kind of things. But basically, going back to the question,
yep.
the emotion is energy in flow from the soul outwards or from a soul inwards.
Mm-hmm.
So it can flow in both directions, of course. But if it's your emotion, then it's flowing from your soul outwards.
Yeah.
And this energy is an expression of your personality, an expression of your individuality as well. So it encompasses all sorts of feelings and desires and passions that you may have. And passions and desires and feelings can all be expressed negatively as well as positively. So the soul's emotions are able to, the energy that's in motion can be expressed negatively, destructively,
mm-hmm.
or it can be expressed creatively. So the energy as it flows out of the soul, you can express that energy in a destructive way. So to do that, you would do something out of harmony with love, and you know, you might get angry or become violent or and so forth. And those kind of things are the expression of that energy in motion, but in a violent or negative way,
yeah.
out of harmony with love. And then the other types of energy that can flow out of the soul is energy that's always in harmony with love. So these are things like passions, desires, longings, the desire to create in harmony with love and so forth. And these feelings that are now energy, they become in motion through the expression of your will.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the other factor about emotion. Emotion is the expression of the soul's will.
Yep.
So you can't intellectually express the soul's will, although the intellectual expression can be triggered by the emotional expression of the soul's will. So what happens with all of our thoughts and therefore all of the things we say, they all come from feelings and emotions, either suppressed or, in other words, used negatively or used positively.
Right.
And these emotions, this energy that's now in motion, causes a trigger of the brains in the mind of the spirit body, the mind of the physical body, and all of a sudden now things get expressed,
yep.
verbally even, with
yep.
language, depending on, of course, what the person has learned
mm-hmm.
in their time frame in terms of how to express themselves emotionally. But the reality is the soul does not need language in order to express its emotion.
Yep.
And interestingly enough, the soul's emotion transcends language. In this sense, that the energy flowing out of the soul is easily recognizable, usually as an expression in the bodies, without there needing to be language expressed.
Yes.
So if someone feels condescending towards you, you will feel an emotion coming out of them mm-hmm. about that, And they won't even have to open their mouth. They won't have to talk in your language. You know they're feeling condescending towards you.
Yes.
And you can see it in their face and see it in their body language and so forth. And this is why most of the expressions of the soul are almost completely independent in many cases of what finishes up coming out of the person's mouth.
Mm. Mm. So just to clarify that, you're saying emotion transcends language.
Yes. So this energy that's in motion, so the energy starts inside the soul and it comes out of the soul in motion. So now it's emotion.
Yeah.
And that emotion transcends any language in the sense that nobody needs to interpret it because you know from the feeling and from the general demeanor of the person what's probably going on. You don't necessarily know why. Uh-huh. But you know what?
Yeah. So I just wanted to clarify, you're saying there's two ways that we sense emotion if we are sensitive ourselves. One is through the way that the emotion affects the body, the spiritual or physical body in terms of demeanour and things like that. But the second is that we can sense it just emotionally without any necessarily physical...
Yes, I wouldn't call the first a way of sensing emotion. I would call it a way of observing the results of the emotion.
Okay.
Whereas to me, the only real way of communicating emotion and receiving the communication of emotion is to be sensitive to the feeling of emotion.
Yeah.
That is the only real way you know for certain what a person is actually feeling.
Yes.
You can, through observation, make certain assumptions. You know, if someone's yelling and screaming and they're going off and they're angry and they're like fuming and there's rage coming out of them, then you can say, oh, he's pretty angry. but if you closed your eyes and closed your ears, there is a soul sense where you can actually feel the rage coming from a person without seeing them and without hearing them.
Yes.
And that's the true sensitivity of the soul. The soul is that sensitive that it's able to feel the flow of emotion from one person to another.
Yeah.
And also, of course, the flow of emotion from God to you. Mm-hmm. So God's feelings for you are emotions, and so God created you sensitive to the flow of emotion. And the way God communicates to you is through this emotional process,
mm-hmm.
this flow of emotion from God to you. And all of the information that God gives you about God and the universe eventually comes through the flow of emotion, not from anything else.
Yep.
So it's a flow of energy coming out of God's soul, if you like, the great oversoul of the universe, if you can call him that. And it knows no boundaries in terms of the speed of light or anything. It's not constrained by the speed of light. It's not constrained by you know, the physical process of having to wait a distance of distance and time.
Yep.
So it's actually, it's not bounded by distance and time. And so it can enter you immediately. As soon as God has the feeling, if you're open emotionally and you are open to God's feelings and you want God's feelings to enter you, because this is all the expression of your soul, the energy that's coming from God's emotion, the energy starts flowing into you,
mm-hmm.
right? And that comes through a connection, if you like. There's a connection that occurs. It's an instant connection and it's unbounded by time and space. It allows you to connect to God emotionally. And the same applies with your connection to people.
Yes.
So in other words, you can sense the feelings of people the instant they have those feelings, and it doesn't matter where they are. They can be here on earth, they could be on the other side of the earth, they can be in the spirit world, and they could be as high as possible in the spirit world. If you become sensitive enough, you'll be able to feel the energy coming from their soul directed at yourself.
Yeah.
And once you're even more sensitive, you'll feel the energy coming from their soul directed at all things and all people. And also different types of people with different types of personalities, you'll feel the energy flowing from their soul. And the personality creates a flavour in this energy.
Yeah.
So the energy can be expressed, and then once it's expressed, once it's allowed to flow and it's expressive and experienced by the person, then it's flowing, it's an emotion then.
Yeah.
And you can feel and sense its flavour.
Yep.
You can feel the personality behind the individual, the flavour of the emotion itself, and what it means about the person. You can feel what they're even trying to say, if they're speaking words to you as well. And sometimes you can even feel, many times in fact, you can feel that what they're saying is completely different to what they're actually feeling.
Yeah.
if you're sensitive to the flow of this energy coming out of the soul, which is emotion.
Okay, a few more clarifiers. You said that emotion, by definition, is flowing.
Yes, it's the energy flowing. It has to be flowing. It can't be just bound up.
Yes. So, first question, what happens when it's bound up?
When it's bound up, it actually is an expression of the soul's will to bind up its own emotion, or deny it, or suppress it, or resist it. Now, once we start doing that with the exercise of our will, which is actually an emotion in itself.
I was going to say, which in itself is an emotion,
correct.
Isn't it?
Yeah. So it's an emotional reason why we are suppressing or denying or resisting.
And that willful use, that willful stop of flow is done through another emotional flow.
Correct. There's always a reason why we do it. There's always a choice. And usually when we stop the flow of emotion, there's only two primary reasons. One is that we're afraid of expressing it. And the second one is that we feel it needs to be suppressed.
Suppressed.
For some reason, you know, and usually because we're worried about becoming out of control or and worried about hurting somebody or something like that. In other words, it's an emotion that is going to probably be negatively expressed and we're worried about the extent of its negative expression. That's usually the only reason why we shut down the expression of emotion. The rest of the time, we're pretty open to the expression of emotion, and most people on the planet are fairly open to expression of certain types of emotion.
Yes.
So, for example, sexually based emotions, which are energy flows based that are sexual in nature, most people on the planet are pretty open to the flow of those particular emotions, whereas other types of flows, it just depends on what's happened to you in the past as to what usually is the reason why you shut down the flow of certain kinds of energy coming from your soul. So once this emotion has... So you could say this emotion is like a build-up of a feeling or energy inside of you, and it's not going to flow, it's not going to become emotion until you allow it. If you suppress it, what it does to your soul is quite damaging. There's a whole heap of pathways inside of your soul, energy-based pathways, that begin being shut down. It's a bit like if you can liken the soul to a brain, which it has some similarities in some ways in terms of its complexity. It's far more complex than the brain. But if you shut down certain pathways inside of your brain, you now no longer have the ability to transmit that particular information. So, for example, if somebody has a stroke, for example, they shut down a certain pathway in their brain that allows that doesn't allow them anymore to express information that's still in their soul, but it no longer can be expressed outwards. And it's a similar principle with regard to how the soul works with emotion. If you begin to suppress or shut down your emotion, in other words, shut down the energy so that it doesn't flow, it starts blocking up all of these different pathways. So you become more and more desensitized. And actually what happens from a, if you could observe the soul, which you can do once you get to the 36th dimension of the spirit world, it starts to shrivel. It's like energy is being taken away from the soul itself. It can't express its energy, and it starts to actually shrivel and looks, it looks like it's dying. Like, and if you can imagine it like an apple, for example, or some kind of piece of fruit sitting out in the open and slowly decomposing without there being any moisture. And what happens is eventually all the moisture disappears from the apple and it just shrivels up and becomes a dried apple. And that's what happens to the soul, like becomes a dried up soul. It still has the capacity to reverse this issue. But unfortunately, a lot of people don't reverse that for many, many years after they pass into the spirit world. So this energy, it's vital that people understand that this energy must flow in order for you to maintain good health. And that's good intellectual and emotional health in the end, because in the end your intellect is completely driven by the emotions or the suppression of the emotions. And for that reason, people who suppress their emotions often become quite disturbed, and in fact you can become so suppressed in your own emotional experience that you allow other people to express their emotions through you, and that would be called psychosis, where you no longer wish to express your own emotions and feelings for whatever reasons, whatever fears you have, but you are completely open to the expression of others through you. And once you do that, you're opening yourself to all sorts of danger with regard to your mental health. And in fact, almost all these problems that are called mental health problems on the planet are all associated with the denial of specific emotions. So at some point in the future, we'll be having a whole series of FAQs about mental health, and we'll actually be pointing out the linkage between what kind of mental health issue a person faces and what type of emotion they are suppressing that created this mental health issue.
Mm.
So, but what we're basically saying is you start locking up this energy emotion and, wow, you start causing all sorts of problems for yourself, but also lots of problems for other people, because other people generally have to now... They now don't have an easy way of determining what you feel. And so now communication is very difficult with you. They don't know what you feel, and unless you can express it verbally, they won't know what you're feeling. Because you're blocking off the expression of your emotion, the expression of the energy. The beauty of having a complete openness from an energy-based expression is that everyone around you knows exactly what's going on. And so it's actually a very loving thing to do as well for everyone around you. Of course, it's not loving for you to project a whole heap of unloving or damaging energy-based emotions where you're making decisions that are damaging other people, but at least everyone knows what you think and feel, even when you're doing that. So the worst potential place for you to be with your emotion is to actually lock it up.
Yeah.
And this is what we're taught to do, unfortunately, on the planet quite from a very, very young age. But it's actually the worst thing you can do to your soul. You're better off expressing it even if it's negatively, because at least some energy is flowing and people can easily determine what's going on. Okay. Of course, the best option is to express your energy, you know, positive, using a positive will in harmony with love. And then, of course, everybody around you will enjoy your company generally and generally enjoy the expression of your personality that they observe.
So you're saying that the nature of the soul is emotional, which is this energy in motion, and it very negatively impacts upon every aspect of health when we shut down emotion.
Correct.
When
we shut down the energy, it's just the energy stored now in the soul. So, for example, if you have an energy like a harmful energy and stored in your soul, so let's say you feel anger, which is an emotion, and you feel the emotion of anger and you decide to suppress that and store that in your soul, now it's going to pervade every single decision you make. It's going to influence everything you do. It's going to determine how everybody around you responds, because it's not being expressed, it's not being released from you. If you express it, it's released. And once it's released, it no longer determines what's happening around you. And an emotion stored, or energy stored within the soul, now creates attractions, because God is always attempting, firstly, to help you express that energy, and secondly, if it's a negative energy, to help you release it.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So God's designed the soul and designed the universe and all of the laws that govern the soul in such a way that God wants you to feel emotion, and God is going to be bringing you events constantly to help you do such a thing, even if the emotion is negative.
Mm-hmm.
Because if the emotion is negative or positive, if you store it, it's going to damage you in some way. It needs an expression, it needs an outlet.
Yep, so when we suppress it, we're essentially trapping it within the soul,
mm-hmm.
and that, regardless of whether that's a positive or negative emotion from what you're saying, that begins to damage us.
Correct. And it's a primary cause of disease. Any negative emotion trapped within the soul that we don't allow the expression of, it's the only cause of all diseases and all accidents and all other things actually that happen to you, whether you are on earth or in the spirit world.
Mm-hmm.
And this is where people don't understand how much it affects their entire existence.
Okay, so if we summarise what you've said, you've said that emotion is energy in motion.
Yes.
And before it's in motion, we can't call it emotion.
No, it's a potential emotion at that point. It's a potential expression of the soul. And it doesn't come out of the soul at that point. So therefore, it's not, you don't see the evidence of the will of the soul at that point so much. And that's you know, what creates a lot of confusion in interactions with other people, of course, because if they can't feel you, they can't feel what you're feeling, and they can't sense what you're feeling, then often people are confused, and then that's when they start using their intellect to try to determine what you're feeling, and they watch your body language to try and determine what you're feeling. But all of that is the outward expression of the emotion that's all blocked up inside of you. And so, you know, if we allow the expression of the emotion in a pure manner, the energy just to flow out of us in a pure manner, it's the simplest interaction you can have with a person. The person knows exactly what's going on inside of you, with one exception, and that is depending on their filters of what they block in terms of their interpretation. Yeah. So in other words, if they're blocking the flow of the emotion coming out of you, and they're filtering it through their own filters, like anger or rage or fear.
So through their own suppression and
through their own suppression
of emotion.
Correct.
That will affect how sensitive they are to what's coming towards them.
Yes, and it will even affect how they interpret the emotion. Mm-hmm. So you could be happy, but they think you're sad. You could be excited, and they think you're angry.
Yes.
You could be excited, and they think you're afraid. Yeah. You know, because of their blocks inside of their soul, they'll often misinterpret the flow of what's coming through to them. So everything gets interpreted through the soul and the soul's will.
Yeah, and so our emotion is an expression of the soul's will.
Yes.
You've said that. But you've also said that emotion is the thing that transcends language, or if you like, it's the soul's way of communication.
Yes, and this is probably the proper way of saying it. It is the soul's language.
Uh-huh.
Emotion is the soul language.
Yeah.
And the language, the words that we use, and even in the spirit world, you might use thoughts rather than words, because you are able to telepathically communicate, particularly in the spirit world, you learn that. Of course, it's a capacity we have here on Earth as well, but most people don't learn it on Earth, so they learn it in the spirit world to telepathically communicate, but they're still communicating thoughts.
Yes.
They're not actually communicating emotion, but the way the soul wants to communicate is emotionally.
Yeah.
So once you become a one with God, you actually are only ever communicating emotionally, and the thoughts are generated by the flow of the emotion. So the emotion is so descriptive that it tells you exactly what to think. So if that makes sense. So in other words, what you're thinking is going to be the complete expression of that soul's emotion. So you could describe it right down to the tiniest detail using language, but it'll be because you're so sensitive to the emotion, it now has a language of its own.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, there's a few things I want to bring up from what you just said.
Sure.
One, you're talking about in the spirit world being so sensitive to emotion that you could almost describe the thoughts, or it creates a thought.
You can describe the thoughts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the case here on Earth now, though, isn't it?
Of course.
All of my thoughts are coming from emotions.
Correct.
Either the suppression or the expression of
Correct, but
emotion.
That's not the way most people interpret them, through their emotions. So what generally happens is this, in terms of communication on Earth, and this is the problem with communication on Earth, mm-hmm. is that we have emotions. We don't usually, we very, very rarely allow their communication. So what we do is that those emotions generate some thoughts.
Yep.
Those thoughts are translated into language. That language drives what we say to somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, on the receiving end, that language gets communicated into thoughts. And of course, unfortunately, that's determined by how their soul is already feeling. So, you know, you can say something to a person, but their soul might be feeling something completely different. And so the thoughts that you're trying to express verbally enters their ears, gets translated into the language, gets translated into thoughts. And then, of course, the thoughts get misinterpreted, because now the emotion determines what thoughts are going to be reflected back into emotion inside of their soul. So it's sort of like we're going emotion, thoughts, language, transmission, reception, language, thoughts, emotion,
yes.
down the other chain.
Yeah.
And there's basically, if you think about it, there's 8 different ways that something can get misinterpreted. And this is why most people misinterpret each other most very frequently, because they can't actually feel the intention, the direct intention of the actual flow of the emotion.
Yeah, and so this is where we were a little while ago, where you were saying that basically, so in an ideal world, if I'm completely open to emotion, so all of the energy within me is flowing, and you are in the same state, then this is the recipe for perfect understanding and communication between two souls.
Correct.
So this is when I'm most fluent in the language of emotion.
Yes, you wouldn't even need to verbally express anything.
Yep.
And the other person, because of their own sensitivity, would know exactly what you're feeling.
Yep.
And even the thoughts it would generate. Because if they are completely at one with God, it would generate the same thoughts within them.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yep.
What are you laughing at?
I was just trying to establish some basic things and you keep throwing in the thoughts. And I'm like, well, can we just get the basics and then I'll add
Let's
that
go back
on.
To the basics and we'll,
because
we'll do all the
when
add-ons.
We, it's kind of like I'm trying to summarize what you've already said to establish the baseline.
More.
And then you keep saying other things and I think, well, we've got to summarize that somehow as well. And then go back. I'm trying to establish for the viewer just the very basics of what you said.
Sure.
And then,
so let's go for the basics.
Yeah. Okay. Energy. Emotion is energy in motion.
Allowed to be in motion.
Allowed to be in motion by the soul.
Yep.
When we shut down that energy, mm-hmm. when we shut down emotion,
yep.
there are a number of flow-on effects.
Yes. It's and now potential energy. It could potentially be allowed to flow.
Yep.
But we're using our will, which is another emotion, as we said.
Yes.
There'll be reasons emotionally why we're using our will to do such a thing.
Yep.
But we're now using our will to shut down the flow of that particular emotion.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So when emotion, when we use our will, and it's always our will that shuts down emotion.
Always. Not ever somebody else's unless we are sensitive to somebody else's feelings and we shut them down because we're sensitive to their feelings. We're afraid of their feelings.
We're afraid of their feelings. But in the end, that fear is an expression of our will also.
Correct. So it's our will being exercised. Yeah. Any shutdown of the soul occurs directly through the expression of our own will.
And obviously, conversely, the same would be true.
With opening it.
Allowing our emotions, again, opening it. It's directly under the impact
control of our own will.
Yep. But when emotions are shut down, there are a number of effects that you've said.
Yes.
Firstly, it causes damage to our soul, our physical body and our spiritual body.
Yes.
Yep, and it's
Can
the cause
I explain
of all
why
illness.
Perhaps it has... Because I haven't explained the link between the soul and the physical and spiritual bodies.
No.
Of course, the soul's energy surrounds both bodies.
Yep.
In other words, the bodies are encapsulated within the soul's energy. So you could think of the soul as a ball of energy, of which you're one half, by the way. You're only one half of the soul, so you've got one half of a ball of energy.
Yep.
And this one half of a ball of energy has encapsulated within it two bodies,
yep.
a physical and a spiritual body. Now, these bodies are all based around how energy, their health is all based around how energy flows
mm-hmm.
within them.
Mm-hmm.
If you shut down the flow of energy in the soul, energy must be shut down in certain parts of these bodies.
Yep.
So these bodies now become shut down with the flow of energy.
Yep.
And this is what causes the damage to the bodies. So the bodies now start getting sick and growing old. And if you shut down your soul enough, you'll die from old age.
Yep.
And this is why everybody on earth finishes up generally dying from old age, because we're so shut down inside of the soul.
Yep.
There's not enough energy flowing from the soul to the bodies to allow the continual replication process to continue. And in fact, it even causes a genetic degradation of the bodies because of the shutdown of the flow of energy in the soul.
Yeah.
So even what we call genetic illnesses are all the result of the shutdown of the flow of the soul's energy.
And sometimes those genetic impacts are passed on to the children through the shutdown in the parents.
Correct. The parents are so shut down to a specific emotion that they, by the time the child is, as soon as the child is conceived, from that moment on, the child feels it also must shut down the same type of energy within itself, because to express it would require a huge amount of opposition to be overcome from the parents. And so the child learns to shut down the exact same emotion.
Yeah.
And once that happens, the child now can then finish up having exactly the same genetic deformity as the parents have.
Yeah.
And this is a common cause of most genetic deformities, in fact, where long lineages of shutdown have occurred in specific areas.
Mm. So basically, you're saying that the soul is the grand controller of everything.
Correct.
Of all experience, thoughts.
Yes.
our physical health, correct, our spiritual body's health. Correct. So the soul's in charge.
It's completely the opposite than most people believe. Most people who have any knowledge of the soul, even in the spirit world, believe that the mind controls the soul, and that is not the case at all. The mind is, the mind, in fact, the mind of the spirit body is just an organ like the brain, and the physical body is an organ, and they are all responding to the soul.
Yep.
So even what happens in the brain and the mind of the spirit body is completely dependent upon what's going on within the soul.
Yep, yep. And so the soul, as this grand controller of everything, its core experience or substance or language is emotion.
Yes.
And so when there's a shut...
Can we say the soul has energy?
Yep.
And its core way of expressing itself is expressing the energy, which is emotion.
Beautiful.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
So the soul has energy, and you can bind it up if you want. You can try to suppress it, resist it, deny that it exists and all those kind of things. But it will come out eventually somehow. Yep. Usually the energy does get expressed.
Yep.
But the soul has energy, and once it comes in motion, it is now being expressed or experienced by that particular person. So in other words, now they're feeling their individual experience, which is a way that they determine their own individuality. It's a way they see their own personality.
Yep.
It causes all sorts of...
It's even the way that we develop our personality and grow, isn't it?
Correct, correct, correct.
Yeah.
So without understanding how the soul actually functions, and then understanding that emotion or energy in motion is the way you express your soul, you're really shutting yourself down quite markedly and causing quite a lot of damage to yourself, to your environment, but also to your bodies and also to your progeny. Any person who is going to be encompassed with your genetic material will also have similar emotional problems as a result of your emotions.
Yeah, so if we could just go back to the point that I was saying about shutting down the emotion, because we've said that we've established very clearly it damages us and our progeny and all of these things that you just said. Mm-hmm. But also there's an important point you were making earlier about understanding each other.
Yes.
And when we shut down emotion, we limit our capacity to be understood and to understand others, even if those others are fully expressing their emotion.
Correct.
If we are shutting down the energy within inside of us, this affects how accurately we understand what's going on in the world around us.
Correct. So if you look at any engagement between two people, there is what's being transmitted out of one individual towards the other person, and then there's what is being received by the other person inside of themselves. And each one of those things are affected by the blocked emotion within each party. So it's like you could see it like a filter, like a lens that you're trying to push light through, and the lens is changing the colour of it depending on how you see things.
Mm-hmm.
And this is how the soul works with regard to its stored emotion. In other words, it's stored energy that's not being expressed. Every emotion it does express has to be expressed through the stored energy.
Yes.
So the stored energy changes the flavour of the expression.
Mm-hmm.
So this means that, you know, you might start out having a happy thought, but by the time you've expressed it, there's a bit of anger in it.
Yes.
And that's because inside you probably have some stored anger-based emotion.
Yep.
And then every time you express any emotion now, it's got to go through that filter.
Mm-hmm.
So if somebody's got sexual injuries, you notice this a lot, for example, where, you know, somebody, what can be a beautiful experience in terms of a sexual engagement with somebody that you love can become a very distorted experience, you know, where people become involved in even what I'd call damaging or violent behaviours in the expression of their sexual energy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all through the filter of their other filters, what they've denied within themselves.
Mm.
And the same applies on the receiving end. So I could, I'm interpreting what's coming at me through my stored, denied and suppressed emotion.
Mm-hmm.
Now, once I'm no longer storing it and denying it and suppressing it, now I've got complete flow, so when that energy comes to me, I can allow that energy to go through me, and therefore I know what's being felt. I can interpret it accurately.
Yes, and this is, so we have the picture where if we're suppressing, everything that we express is filtered through this injury. Everything we receive is filtered through this injury.
Correct.
But conversely, if we're completely open emotionally, we become sensitive, very sensitive to what's happening around us.
Mm-hmm.
And this is where...
Whether that's in the spirit world with people we can't see or people on earth. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where they are.
Yes.
They could be anywhere in the universe and you can feel them.
And with God.
Yes.
Herself.
Same applies, of course. And as long as there is an openness to God, of course.
Yes. So we have to be open.
Have to be open to the individual.
Emotionally, to everything. This is the... Yes. If I'm speaking.
Yes.
And this is where humility leads us to truth, doesn't it? In that if we're open to... Or, well, maybe that's too big a leap.
Yeah, but...
If we're open to everything emotionally, we then have access to the truth of what's happening because we have no filter inside of us.
Correct.
And then
in practice, though, it's not like that. Because initially, when we're interacting with people, when we've been born on this earth, we already have, through the gestation period, we've already imbibed many emotions that are now filtering
exactly.
our souls. So by the time we're even born, we're already filtering a lot of the information coming into our soul, so therefore we're misinterpreting it.
Yep.
And unfortunately, it requires a slow process to reverse that
yes.
condition. But for most people on earth, they never reverse that condition.
No.
And so most people on earth grow in their misinterpretation of other people.
Yes, yes. But you had mentioned this ideal circumstance where the soul's language is in play.
Yes.
When there is no emotional impediment,
yes.
all energy is flowing through you,
yes.
then you are completely in contact with the truth and the reality of what's happening
Correct.
Around you.
Correct. Yep. And if you think about it, potentially we could have children born in that state, that they are completely open to the flow of all the emotion around them and can interpret it correctly based on what they've learnt already while they're in the womb.
Yeah.
And as a result of that, they'd be very, very well-developed children in love, but also in their intellectual knowledge. Because when there is no emotional impediments, intellectual understanding also is now rapidly expanded and improves exponentially with the release of each emotion.
Yeah.
So once a person is free of negative emotions that cause the impedance of energy flowing within the soul, they now have the ability to have far more understanding and growth than they ever had before. And this is why the majority of people on earth don't grow very much intellectually, because there are so many impediments emotionally to the growth.
Mm.
So this is why the energy locked up emotionally, like as I said earlier, people have no understanding of how damaging it is. It's like it's damaging everything. It damages not only you, but also everyone around you. It damages also every interaction you have. Every single thing that you do is misinterpreted or misexpressed, not expressed accurately, because of the stored energy that's in your soul that's preventing the flow of that energy outwards and also within yourself.
Mm. Okay, beautiful. You covered so much information
yeah,
there.
Obviously, there's a lot more we could say.
Yes.
But it's important for people to understand why we're made this way as well. I feel like God made us this way so that this beautiful, smooth communication can actually occur. So every interaction in the celestial spheres of the spirit world are actually this beautiful, smooth communication. Everyone understands everyone.
Yeah.
No one misunderstands somebody else. Everyone, you don't need to say anything. Sometimes you do because you want to. You know, it's a part of your expression, in your language and so forth. And you can speak any language then. So you speak any language. But you have thoughts and you can telepathically communicate those thoughts. But the reality is the real communication is happen emotionally.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you really feel and sense the person. And that's also how you feel and sense God.
Mm.
In fact, there is no other way of communicating with God. In fact, God does not communicate intellectually or with words. And so any person who says to you that God, talk to me, well, no, it's impossible, in fact. God does not talk to people. God expresses himself emotionally with people, and words may appear in their mind as a result of that. But if they're hearing words directly with no expression of God's emotion, then it means it's just another spirit or another person talking in a language to them.
Yeah.
And many people on earth misinterpret what they call God's voice is not God's voice.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the voice of a person they can't see.
Yeah. Yep. Mm.
So there's so many things we could say about emotion and how important it is. And, we've done a whole series of seminars, just started them recently, about the importance of emotion. But I thought initially it's great to define what it is.
It is. And it's very difficult to to not digress slightly to give context to what you're saying there,
course,
and
yeah.
to give examples. So I was trying to rein you in a little, you know, just to try to keep it...
as quite nice as possible.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
But it it is a very complex thing, though.
It is
very complex because the soul is a very complex creation. It is the most complex creation that God has ever done. So it's far more complicated than the universe itself, actually, the soul, mm-hmm. in terms of its intricacy. And it's far more complicated than the human brain and also the spirit body's brain. It's far more complicated than any other organ or even all organs together in the physical body and the spirit bodies. It's far more complicated than all those things. Mm. So it's really important that we understand the basics of how it functions.
Yeah, and you say it's complicated, but in fact it's a very simple system, isn't it?
Yes.
That is full of beautiful intricacy that functions well if we just embrace some core things,
yes.
some core emotions, if
yes.
you like. But because there's so much injury on the planet emotionally,
yes.
it all becomes very complex. And yeah. explaining it from all the different ways it can go wrong and be right.
Yeah.
the different applications for these truths,
yeah.
that then it becomes a complex kind of discussion.
Of course, you could speak for millennia
yes.
about an emotion and how yeah. it operates and still have somebody intellectually not understand what's really going on until they actually feel what's going on inside of their soul.
Yeah.
And the other thing to bear in mind with all of this too is that the soul has the capacity to infinitely expand mm-hmm. through some capacities that God gave it through the reception of God's love. So God's love becomes like a switch that allows the soul to transform from its original creation into a new creation. Mm. So there's a whole series of complex issues in that
yes.
that are affected by the flow of energy inside
yeah.
of the soul. And we need to understand that not only has the soul been created finitely under certain circumstances, and the circumstance obviously is if we're not connected with God, but the soul also has this potential of infinite expansion,
mm-hmm.
which means the emotions also have the potential of infinite expansion, and therefore the power has the potential of infinite expansion, and these potentials alone mean that the soul is being created so complex. That I feel that it doesn't matter how long the human examines the subject of the soul, they still will not know everything about the soul.
Yeah.
So while there are many spirits who know lots of things, well, pretty much everything about the physical body and lots of things about the spirit body, there's no single person at this point in time, aside from God, who knows everything about the human soul.
Yeah. So perhaps then, just to finish, some of the really key things that you've said about emotion,
mm-hmm.
energy and motion. It's not thoughts but create thoughts.
Correct.
That emotions are passions and desires and an expression of our will.
Yes.
And we can choose to express them negatively or positively. So in a way
and
that
even that's driven by an emotion.
Yes.
Usually.
An expression of our will, which
yes.
is emotional, but it can be damaging or it can be healing and creative.
Yes. Yes. Yep. God created us naturally. It probably should be said in closing on the session
mm-hmm.
that God created us naturally to express our emotion in harmony with love. And it's only other things that occur, decisions that we make.
Yep.
that cause anything other than that to occur.
Mm.
And this is the expression of our will. And our will is determined not by injuries. It's determined by other processes within the soul where we start to develop desires
yeah.
that then become expressed. And desires finish up usually becoming expressed emotionally. And this is our soul using its emotional expression, its flow of energy, if you like, emotion,
mm-hmm.
in a way that it can, either in harmony with love or in disharmony with love.
Yep.
So it's important for people to understand that you can use the energy within inside of yourself to flow in a positive way, in harmony with love, or in a negative way out of harmony with love. And God created you with the freedom to do so.
Yeah. Yep. And that goes for whether the emotion that is within us is in harmony with love or out of harmony with love, doesn't it?
Correct.
It's still possible to have an emotion within us that's out of harmony with love that we choose to deal with
by allowing its expression in a loving way.
Yep.
So in other words, we might be angry.
Yeah.
So way that might happen is we might be angry, and we decide rather than dumping it on our partner whom we're angry with, we go into our room and we feel the emotion, and we eventually get back to what the cause was,
mm-hmm.
and we feel the emotional reason why we were triggered into anger under those circumstances. And that's using, that's even allowing the flow of negative emotion,
yes.
in a positive manner,
yeah.
in a healing manner.
Yeah, beautiful. Mm. Thank you very much.
Pleasure.